Hi students, in this video, let us discuss about the parse tree or derivation tree. In the previous video, we have discussed about the context-free grammar introduction. So, what is context-free grammar? What is the formal definition of context-free grammar? And what are the rules for recognizing a particular grammar as a context-free grammar? So, now in this video, let me define a parse tree or derivation tree. A parse tree is an ordered rooted tree that graphically represents the semantic information of strings derived from a context-free grammar. So, using the context-free grammar, we can derive any number of strings. To determine the semantic information of those strings, we can use a parse tree or derivation tree. So, this parse tree or derivation tree is possible only for the context-free grammar, because there are some similarities between the context-free grammar and a tree. So, generally, whenever we say the rules for a tree, every tree must have a root. So, here also, in case of context-free grammar, the root vertex must be labeled by the start symbol. So, CFG contains a unique start symbol, which may be used as a root. As we have seen in the previous lecture, in the production rule, alpha generates beta, alpha belongs to V, where V represents a single variable. So, that is why the starting symbol S may be mapped to the root of the tree. And similarly, the second property of a tree is the tree contains intermediate vertex or leaves. So, similarly, in case of context-free grammar, there are two types of components. So, one is variables or non-terminals, and terminals, combination of variables and terminals. So, here the variables may be mapped to the intermediate vertices, and the terminals may be mapped to the leaves. So, that is the similarity between context-free grammar and tree. Vertex labeled by non-terminal symbols. So, here vertex means intermediate vertices. They are labeled by non-terminal symbols. Leaves labeled by terminal symbols are epsilon. As we know, beta belongs to V plus T whole star. It may contain either variables or terminals or epsilon. So, we may map the leaves either to the terminal symbols or to the epsilon. So, that is why the context-free grammar is mapped to CFG, is mapped to a tree very easily, because the properties of the context-free grammar and the properties of tree matches. Where this type of mapping is not possible in any other type of grammars. Now, let us derive the parse tree or derivation tree for the given grammar. So, as we know, the formal definition of the context-free grammar is G is equal to VTPS, where V represents the set of variables or non-terminals, T represents the set of terminals, P represents the production rules, S represents the start symbol. So, here the production rules are given as S generates 0B, A generates 1AA or epsilon, B generates 0AA. So, as we know, the root of the tree must be the start symbol S. S generates 0B. So, because 0 is terminal symbol, we need not to further expand this tree branch, because B is a variable or non-terminal, we need to generate further. So B generates what production? 0 AA. 0 AA. Now because this zero is a terminal symbol, we need not further expand. So however, we can expand this A as well as this A. Now whether to expand this A or this A, so is basically determined in two different ways, known as the leftmost derivation or rightmost derivation. So whenever we follow the leftmost derivation, then it is called as left derivation tree. Left derivation tree. And whenever we follow the rightmost expansion, then it is called as right derivation tree. So we can follow either left derivation or right derivation. For example, if I follow the left derivation, so A generates 1 AA. 1 AA. And for this A, we may generate epsilon, because if you keep on generating, the same generations will be applied. So that is why we go for epsilon. And for this A also, I may replace with epsilon. Now what is the string generated? The string generated is 0, 0, 1, epsilon, epsilon, epsilon. 0, 0, 1. Epsilon, 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 which is equivalent to 0, 0, 1, because epsilon represents null string. If the same derivation is performed as right derivation tree, how could we perform? So we take the start symbol 0, B, because B is the only variable we are going to derive. 0, A, but here instead of expanding the leftmost variable, we are going to expand the rightmost variable. So rightmost variable is this A. Now I am going to substitute this 1 AA for this particular A. 1 AA. And now I am going to replace epsilon from right side onwards. So I am going to replace epsilon for this A, epsilon for this A, and epsilon for this A. Now what is the string generated? 0, 0, epsilon, 1, epsilon, epsilon. So this string is also equivalent to 0, 0, 1. So based on this concept, now we are going to define left derivation tree and right derivation tree. Left and right derivation trees. A left derivation tree is obtained by applying production to the leftmost variable in each step, as we have seen in the previous example. A right derivation tree is obtained by applying production to the rightmost variable in each step. Now, let me take one more example and find out the left derivation tree and right derivation tree so that you will have more clarity. Generate the string AABAA from the given grammar. S generates AAS, ASS or epsilon. A generates SBA or BA using both left and right derivation trees. So first let me generate using the left derivation. Initially, as usual, I shall take the start symbol as the root of the tree. And now S generates AAS or ASS or epsilon. So among these derivations, I shall take any of these derivations. So I will take ASS, because after A, I need one more A. If I take this particular generation, So it represents A, AS, where A generates BA. So I could not get one more A. That is why I will take A, S, S. Now, how many variables are there? Two variables are there, because we are following the left derivation. So we are going to expand this particular S. So for this S, now I am going to apply A, A, S, because I need only one more A. A, A, S. Again, I got two variables, A and S. So, what is the given string? A, A, B, A, A. Now, I got A, 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 A. And I need to get B, A, A. So, for that purpose, I am going to expand this A with the derivation B, A. B, A. Now, I need to get one more A. If I get one more A, then the given string will be generated. So, as S generates epsilon, now I shall take this particular production, ASS. You can see here, A is terminal, A is terminal, B is terminal, A is terminal. What is the leftmost variable now? S. So, I am going to generate S, A, Yes, yes. Now, what are the string given that has been completed? A, A, B, A, A. As S generates epsilon, I am going to replace S with epsilon. This S also generates epsilon. So, what is the string generated? A, A, B, A, epsilon, epsilon. Epsilon. So this is equivalent to A, A, B, A, A. So as I have expanded the leftmost variable, so this type of derivation is called left derivation tree. Now let me show you the right derivation tree for the same production. I will start the right derivation tree from here. Let me take the start symbol as S, which becomes the root of the tree. And then, once again, I shall use A, S, S. Now, there are two variables. So, instead of expanding the leftmost variable, I need to expand the rightmost variable. So, for the rightmost variable S, I am going to take this production A, S, A, A, S, A, A, S. And once again, I need to expand the rightmost variable. Now, what is the rightmost variable? This S. So, I will take A, S, S for this variable, A, S, S. So, I am taking similar to the left derivation tree. Here you may observe, I have taken A, S, S, A, S, S. After that, I have taken A, A, S, A, A, S. Okay, but, so this is left derivation, this is right derivation. A, S, S. Okay. And for this particular S, for the rightmost S, once again, I take A, 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 S, S. A, yes, yes. So, now we may observe that what is the string A, A, B, A, A. From right side, we need to compare A, A. This A has come. So, what I need to get from right side, B, A. From right side, I need to get B, A. However, if I expand this A and substitute with BA, then for example, if I consider BA here, then how many A's will come? 1, 2, 3 A's will come, whereas I need to get only 2 A's. So that is why I need not to expand the rightmost S here, not needed. Instead of that, because I am following the rightmost derivation. So now if you observe, if I place BA for this A, now the string will be correct. A, B, A. However, as we need to follow the rightmost derivation, so initially I should not expand A, but I should expand S. So this S value I don't need. So that is why, because S generates epsilon, I am going to replace epsilon. For this S also, I am going to replace epsilon. Now, what is the variable remaining? This A. For this A, I am going to derive B A. And this is already a terminal. And one more variable is there, S. So for this S also, I am going to replace epsilon. So now you may observe the string is correct. A, B, A. So what is the string we generated? A, epsilon, B, A. Sorry, A, epsilon, this A, B, A, epsilon. So which is equivalent to A, B, A. So we have successfully generated the same string using the right derivation tree. So this is how we are going to generate the left derivation as well as right derivation of a parse tree. So if you like this video, subscribe to our channel and share this video to your friends and colleagues. That's all for now.